Thirukkural from Hemsar, a poet who has written about everything under the sun. And he has said 2000 years ago, Eenral Mugatheyum Innadath Enmattru Chandror Mugathu Kali. This translates to, a mother normally absolves her or protects her children from any kind of crimes which they are accused of, sir. But even she, when even she will not support a addict behavior, a drunken behavior, what can you expect of learned people? So the importance of staying without addiction is being exemplified even 2000 years ago. And so many people have spoken about this bill, where this bill was brought in 1985 and subsequently amended several times. And in 2014, the act was amended and the clause number, there was a change in the clause number where the punishment was not commensurate with the clause number, and that has been rectified in this amendment. So as every other speaker before me, Mr. Mahatab and Mr. Manish Tiwari had said, any act when you bring, if you are going to say that it is going to have retrospective effect, instead of saying from 2014, if you say that it is having retrospective effect from 100 years, I don't know how many people will fall under the under this law where they will be found culpable, sir. Similarly, just like how it was earlier mentioned, that this will open floodgates for in the future where any kind of an amendment can be made with retrospective effect, I think this should be avoided. Sir, we are also talking about an act where you have to understand what narcotic substances are and what psychotropic substances are. Narcotic drugs are substances that cause stupor, muscular relaxation and reduction or elimination of sensitivity. This is basically something where it removes pain. Whereas psychotropic substances are chemical substances that act on the mind, that is on the conscious or unconscious mental life of an individual. This is something where the main crux of the issue lies, where the youngsters nowadays are getting carried away with these things, sir. Sir, under this act, we have 238 drugs. Going through this list of 238 drugs, I don't know, I would really like to ask the government, how many of these substances have the number of cases been filed? How many of these drugs have been found with in possession or in abuse? Because out of this 238 drugs, the commonly talked about drugs are only about ganja, tetrahydrocannabinol, cocaine, and I mean like some other chemical compositions which are very few, sir. So I would request the government to see if these 238 drugs, whether these are actually being abused and whether this list can be shortened. Because I don't even know if the enforcement agencies will have knowledge about all these drugs in question. And also talking about this amendment which is being brought, it is sad to note that the CJA of the Supreme Court, the Chief Justice, he has observed that passing bills without adequate debate has caused a lot of confusions in the judiciary, sir. Sir, when we are talking about bills without adequate debate, what can we speak about ordinances? I mean, like when this government, this is a bill which could have been brought in during this winter session, and this could have waited 2 months, sir. This was brought in on September 30th, 2021, and this could have waited for 2 months. But what was the need to bring out an ordinance? Was it for a particular case? Our learned member from Dhule, Maharashtra, he had spoken so highly, accused saying that Bollywood, it is so rampant in Bollywood. If he believes that this drug abuse is there only in Bollywood, I will say that he is in a paradise, sir. I mean, like, I don't know what paradise he is in. Because today, drug abuse, especially ganja and tetrahydrocannabinol, cannabis, has pervaded into schools, sir. Forget about colleges and other walks of life. Today, school children have access to these kind of contraband, and it is the duty of the government to ensure that the sale of these drugs, these things, should be contained. When they are talking so proudly, or they take such glee in talking about Bollywood, they do not raise a single question, neither the treasury benches nor the media, they do not raise a single question about the huge haul of drugs which were caught in one of the ports, sir. Why is it that everybody is silent about that? What is the status of the drugs which amounting to several thousands of kgs was caught, and there is no mention or talk about that? So I feel that it is a sad state of affairs that we are talking about addiction, and we are also talking, let's not assume that the government has brought in this bill for the welfare of the citizens of this country. Because the honorable member who is not here now, he is a doctor, and I will say that cigarette and alcohol, these are the two biggest threats and biggest problems in this country, sir. The earlier member was talking about cannabis being sold in the roads. Today, cigarettes are being sold in the roads. And though you have an advisory which says that this can cause cancer and this should not be sold to school children, how much of this is being enforced? You find shops outside schools, colleges, everywhere, and the sale of cigarettes is rampant everywhere, sir. And being a doctor, I can say that smoking does not have absolutely any medicinal benefit at all, sir, arguably, because there is only one topic where they talk about preeclampsia, where they say that smoking probably reduces BP in people, in ladies who are suffering from preeclampsia. But for that, smoking is one of the biggest health hazards which causes a lot of respiratory problems, cancers throughout the bodies, and not only in the lungs. It causes cancers in several parts of the body like the pancreas, urinary bladder and other substances. But we do not talk about smoking. We do not talk about alcohol. Sir, one of the biggest psychotropic substance which causes most of the social evils, be it familial, personal, health-wise, to everybody in the family concerned. I have seen families in my state, the alcohol, there is a lot of problems where families are left because these men die at a young age, leaving their family destitute, sir. So when we have these kind of issues, why are we talking so much about these drugs and we are not even taking adequate action against the people who are selling them or trafficking in them? We are only targeting the people who are found in possession, and that too of small quantities. And we have a law which says that people who are having small quantities of these drugs should be imprisoned for 6 months. So I find that very strange, because there are several countries where some of these drugs, especially cannabis, has been legalized. I am not saying this government should legalize cannabis, but to say a person who is in possession of a small quantity of a drug will be penalized, where he'll be sentenced for 6 months of jail, I think is unacceptable, sir. I feel that we should give them adequate provision, and we should, even probably the government should take steps to ensure that rehabilitation is provided for these people, either if they can afford it on their own, or if not, if the government can sponsor rehabilitation. That is a way forward. Instead of trying to see how a person can be victimized and who can be taken to task, where the government legally permits the sale of alcohol throughout the country. So in this kind of a situation, I would request that the government take adequate steps to ensure that ordinances of this nature are not promulgated, and give opportunity for the subject to be discussed and debated in parliament. And though you have a brute majority, I have seen number of times where the opposition members of parliament, on trivial issues, when they asked for an amendment, I feel that there is no great support from the treasury benches. I request that the treasury benches can consider some of these amendments which are being said in the right spirit to be taken up in the same spirit and to help parliament function better. So thank you very much.
In the video, please like and share. Marakama, inga channel, subscribe.